Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. In today's video we are talking about plastic minimalism. And I will start with explaining what I mean when I say plastic minimalism. I intentionally did not call this video a zero waste video, because zero waste is about a lot more than just the plastic waste we leave behind on this planet. Zero waste is also about emissions, greenhouse gases and so much more. I made a video in the past in which I shared some small and easy zero waste tips, and in this video I'm sharing how I avoid a big chunk of plastic waste. It takes a little bit more effort, but it also has a way bigger impact. When I started minimizing my plastic, I realized that by far the biggest amount of plastic entered my home through the grocery store. So the first big change I made was going to the farmer's market. I've been shopping at the farmer's market for over a year now, and this has saved me a lot of plastic. But there were still quite a lot of items that I still needed to get at the grocery store. But recently I was able to place an order at a zero waste grocery store that sells food in jars. I've been on the waiting list for half a year, so I guess this service is quite popular and gaining popularity. The store is trying to expand their capacity, which makes me very happy. Selling the food in glass jars and shipping it to your home has a lower CO2 emission than if I were to buy these groceries in recycled cardboard boxes at my local grocery store. And it allows me to buy these foods without packaging, which was not available to me elsewhere. The jars are of very nice quality and they look really pretty, so that's a nice bonus. And when you return the jars, you receive your deposit and then they will clean out the jars and refill them. Being able to buy less plastic waste gives me hope, and it also makes me very grateful that I can be part of a better, less wasteful future. Sometimes I think it's very strange that plastic packaging is so normalized. With every item we buy, we get another item which we didn't even want to have in the first place, the packaging. If we were to get, I don't know, a Barbie doll with every item we bought, we would get pretty annoyed pretty fast. But because plastic packaging is so normalized, we accept it mindlessly as part of the deal, and we throw it away immediately because we have absolutely no use for it. And I know that in some cases the packaging can prolong the shelf life of products, but the amount of plastic is often very excessive and many products are fine without packaging or can be packaged in alternative ways. In some cases I still choose to buy plastic packaging because I'm not able to buy a certain item without it. I think when you try to buy plastic-free groceries, you have to put everything that comes in plastic on the scale. Because there are items that are healthy and good for you that you are not able to find without any plastic. And then you have to decide if you want to lower your plastic waste or if you want to eat the healthy foods. For example, celery and broccoli are often very hard to find without plastic, but they are very tasty and very healthy. So for me, health comes first, and I do buy these items. I just try to find a good balance in buying plastic-free, buying food in jars, and buying some food in plastic. Here I'm making a nice and fresh salad from the foods I could buy zero waste. And another way I reduce waste is by composting, so all the scraps will go on the compost pile. We have the compost pile in the chicken meadow, so the chickens can eat whatever they like, and the other scraps will be compost and will be used in the garden to grow veggies next season. We usually put the compost on the garden once a year. It's very good nutrition for your garden, and it basically means we don't have any green waste. I'm making a dressing with the olive oil I just received with my order, and I'm also putting in some lemon juice, some salt and some pepper. I'm also adding the couscous I ordered. I'm boiling it in some boiling water and then add it to my salad. Mix everything together and add the dressing. And then the meal is done and ready to eat. I'm not only trying to avoid single-use plastic, I'm also trying to avoid plastic in general. So the salad bowl is made from glass, the spoons are from wood, and I use a small coconut bowl to eat from. I got these bowls for my birthday a while ago, and I absolutely love them. They are so beautiful and unique, and they make every meal look super pretty. I prefer more natural materials in my everyday use, but I did make the conscious decision to not throw away all my plastic items immediately, but rather replace them gradually, because I know the plastic items will very likely not be recycled, so I will donate them to the thrift store, but you never know if they will actually ever get used again. But since I now have these beautiful coconut balls, I might get rid of my plastic balls in the future. To make our compost pile work even better, we also put brown paper and cardboard boxes on it. Composting is actually quite simple. To get a good composting process, you need 2 parts brown material and 1 part green material. So it's very good to put cardboard in there. Just make sure you don't put any printed paper in, because the ink will not decompose. We do not only try to minimize our own plastic, we also try to minimize the plastic our dog takes in. There are actually no rules or regulations about safety for dog toys, which is ridiculous because dogs constantly have the toys in their mouth, so there's a high chance they get some of it in their system. So that's why I have a rope for our dog to play with, and we also have this natural rubber dog toy which he absolutely loves. It is called an Eggy Ball. It is completely safe, it's completely free from coloring, weak makers or any other chemicals, so he can chew on it all day, and we know it will not harm him. Next, I'm going to show you how I make biodegradable laundry detergent. I'm going to start with grating a piece of natural soap. Right now I'm using Castilla soap, because this is what I happen to have on hand, but when I run out, I also want to try this recipe with Marseille soap. For a regular sized bottle of detergent, you need between 30 and 50 grams of grated soap. After the soap is grated, I add it to hot water, and I also add 10 drops of sweet orange essential oil, but of course you can add any scent you like. This recipe is a detergent for color wash, but if you want to make a detergent for whitewash, you can also add a couple of tablespoons of cleaning soda, because it has a little bit of a bleaching effect, so that's why you shouldn't put it in color wash. So today I'm not using any soda. I'm just reusing this bottle of detergent over and over again. When the detergent cools down, it turns into a slimy, jelly consistency, and I use 50 to 70 milliliters on 1 load of laundry. I've been using this detergent for quite a while now, and it cleans pretty well. The scent doesn't really last on your clothing, but I personally don't really mind that. And I also put the washing cycle on eco mode, so it saves energy and water. Now I'm going to show you how I make my own dish soap. We need some warm water, cleaning soda, baking soda, a bottle, and that's it. For a regular sized bottle of dish soap, I'm using 1 big tablespoon of baking soda and also 1 big tablespoon of cleaning soda. We mix everything together and pour it in the bottle. When it cools down, it stays liquid and it doesn't make foam, but it washes perfectly. So I want to talk a little bit about dishwashers, because it slightly annoys me that dishwashers are being greenwashed, because I don't think they are better for the environment than washing the dishes by hand. I haven't done any research about it. This is just common sense for me, so I wanted to share it with you. We actually do have a dishwasher in this house. It's over here, but we've never actually used this dishwasher. And today I wanted to share with you why. There are people who say that research has shown that a dishwasher is better for the environment than hand washing. I'm not saying there is not research that has been done to prove that, but I wonder what kind of situations they use to actually make that evidence. Was the dishwashing done while running the tap for the entire time, or was it done while filling a tub of water and doing the dishes in that? Because I can imagine that it costs a lot more water and energy if the tap is running for the entire time of doing the dishes, in comparison to just making a tub of hot water and washing the dishes in that. So that's the first variable which we don't know about. And then there's also the thing that they probably didn't take in account, that producing the dishwasher also takes a lot of energy. All the resources that are needed to produce a dishwasher are very bad for the environment. And also, after the dishwasher breaks, we are left with a big machine that either needs to be recycled, which also takes a lot of energy, or some of the machine will be waste on this planet, which is also pretty bad. And I think that you also should consider who paid for the research, because I think it's probably funded by a company that produces dishwashers and wants to sell them, so they have an interest in a specific outcome and they can manipulate the kind of research that has been done. And nobody who wants to have a greener world has the funds to set up a research to prove that washing by hand is more eco-friendly, so nobody does that. It's an answer that people want to hear. People would like to have an easier option that takes less effort, which is better for the environment, than something that takes effort, like doing the dishes by hand. It makes people feel good about buying a product that is also just trashing the planet, just like any other product. So it's actually a pretty good selling tactic, but yeah, I don't believe it. Well, I'm just going to finish washing these dishes. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please give it a like, and I hope you consider subscribing to my channel. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye!